Welcome back to the Teeniest Pinecone. Remember when I said I wasn't going to be here till next month? Well, I decided to surprise you with a reading journal setup. I was always a pretty avid reader, but ironically have not read much of anything since the world has been in this situation, so I thought making a reading journal would help me get back into the swing of things and challenge myself. So we're starting with a sort of introductory spread, and I'm just using a Polaroid that I took from a secondhand bookshop in my hometown that I really, really love. I went to visit over the summer after being in isolation for like a year, so it was really nice to get to see my family and friends and get to visit all the places that I'd been missing. And here I'm using the Vintage Rose stamp set by Notebook Therapy. I adore their products, and I'm so happy that this presented the opportunity for me to use more of them because they are so beautiful. And I pretty much used their stamps on every page of this spread. And here I'm using my Sakura Pigma Micron fineliner to outline a picture that I found on Pinterest to kind of match my dark slash light academia theme that I chose for this. Also, if this looks really overexposed, it's because I'm living in the UK right now, where the sun comes out for approximately 3 seconds every day, and that just so happened to be this very moment. And since this is not your typical bullet journal, it didn't need a full-on grid spacing guide, so I just wrote the amount of the spaces and dots along the side and the top of the page, so I could refer to them in the future if I needed them. Next up is the reading tracker, and for this, I didn't have a specific number that I was really aiming for. While I still want to challenge myself, I don't want to stress myself out. I know there are a lot of people who set their goals to like 100, 120, 130 books in a year, and I think the most I've ever done is like 52, if I'm remembering my Goodreads goal correctly. So I'm just gonna see how this year goes and focus on being excited about the things that I read rather than having to maintain a certain flow. And I've realized that I'm actually a pretty slow reader. When I do read, I imagine everything in my head as if it's a movie playing out, so it's really cinematic and I see camera angles and I hear voices and accents and probably a little bit extra, but that's how my brain processes the information. So getting through a book really takes me longer than it probably should. And I've probably given myself even more spaces than I actually need this year, but we'll see how far I can get. The quote that I've chosen here is, "The person who deserves the most pity is a lonesome one on a rainy day who does not know how to read," by Benjamin Franklin. And there are a lot of quotes the world seems to believe he said that he did not, so I wasn't entirely sure he'd actually said this, but all of my sources seem to confirm that he did, so that is what I'm sticking to. So, like I said, over the last couple years, I haven't really been reading very much. However, one of the series that I did decide to reread last year was the ACOTAR series, and that kind of kickstarted my obsession with fantasy literature at the moment. So I went to Reddit and I asked people to give me recommendations for fantasy books similar to the feeling of ACOTAR with a more mature prose, and what you'll see in a minute is the many, many books that Redditors gave to me, which I am super excited to dive into. Also, what you're seeing is that I hated the title that I previously wrote and used craft paper and stamps to cover it up, and I'm way happier with it. And this is my garden spread, where I will be tracking how many pages I've read each week throughout the year, so it's gonna look a little bit sad right now, but it goes through week 52, and essentially I'm going to place a dot for the number of pages every single week, and then at the end of the year, turn those dots into a flower garden, or an herb garden, or something of the like. So by the time the new year comes, I will have a pretty image to depict the fruits of my labor. are on the very first monthly. So I'm making this in March, but I'm starting the journal in January because that was the first month that I actually started reading. So I'm essentially playing catch up. I might at some point do a flip through of this journal just so I can show you the spreads of the books that I've made. I've already made about 4 or 5 so far, but the titles are going to be listed on the left-hand side on this little makeshift library card, and the date of checkout is going to be the date that I actually started reading the books. The stamp I bought on Etsy, and I thought it was really cute and looked really vintage, even though it's not vintage at all. Libraries still use these, so I don't know what my brain was thinking, but I thought it was a cute idea. We'll definitely link that seller down below, as well as all of the other supplies that I'm using, which honestly aren't many. This setup is really not very illustration heavy, just a few minor doodles here and there. I did fill in the little notebook therapy postage stamp with some cute bookish things to make it look like it could actually be a design on a little card somewhere. And this is where the husband came home and brought me coffee, for which I am eternally grateful. He just gets it, you know? And now I'm pasting in my Polaroid. I just waited till the end because I didn't want to make my spreads directly on top of it and risk ruining the image, so we're doing it now. I wrote the name of the bookshop underneath, the Iliad Bookshop in North Hollywood. If you are ever in the area, definitely check them out. They're a cute local business with bookstore cats that just kind of roam around and visit you while you read on their couches. It's the cutest little place. And now we depart, sadly. Links are in the description, including my Instagram, and I'll see you for April.